एक्सपीरियंस के लिए ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, क्योंकि आपको मेरी टेक्निक जो रहती थी प्रीलिम्स में, वो हमेशा मुझे एलिमिनेशन पे मैं फोकस करता था। एलिमिनेशन कैसे, कि मैंने अपना जो टेस्ट सीरीज लगाता था उसमें मेन फोकस मेरा ये होता था कि किस तरीके से ऑप्शंस को एलिमिनेट करना है, और जो बचा हुआ है वो मेरा आंसर रहता था। तो कभी कभी मुझे लगता है कि यूपीएससी में कुछ लोग गलती करते हैं कि सिलेक्शन ही ढूंढने लगते हैं, सही व्हाट इज राइट उसमें जाते हैं, तो बहुत मुश्किल हो जाता है निकालना, क्योंकि सबको सब कुछ नहीं पता
होता।
तो मेरा तो टारगेट यही रहता था कि मैं किस तरीके से एलिमिनेट कर सकूँ, और वो टेक्निक बहुत हेल्प करती है। और आप यूपीएससी के प्रीवियस ईयर्स अगर पेपर्स उठाओगे प्रीलिम्स के खासकर, वो तो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है इस चीज़ के लिए। आप देखो यूपीएससी का एक सेट पैटर्न है, क्वेश्चन सेट करने का, ऑप्शन सेट करने का, उसको एलिमिनेट करने का। तो एक बार वो चीज़ आपने अगर समझ ली तो काफी हद तक इजी हो जाता है प्रीलिम्स को।
No one can ever finish the syllabus for this exam. It's massive, especially the prelims. I think is the toughest part.
Read from the perspective of mains examination. Understand the story. Understand the logic. Understand the concept. And that is going to be the fundamental. That is going to be the basis for which or from which you can derive and deduce the answer of the prelims examination.
If you are keeping your sources limited, that's the best part. You will be done with NCERT revision within 4 or 5 days. You will be done with, if you make notes like one diary, one page, one policy, तो वो जल्दी हो जाता है।
So you will never be able to say कि oh I'm completely prepared, I have everything. Revise what you have, and if you do the mocks, you'll have the understanding to do, to know whether what is the element of how much I know and how much I want to guess.
अगर paper difficult है तो सबके लिए difficult है. This is a relative exam. You have to just beat the majority of the people. You have to clear the cutoff. Do not have to top in this particular examination. So prelims mein kya rehta hai ki it requires continuous revision of the content which you have prepared, hai na? Because isme dekhiye there is a lot of factual information.
So for knowledge, I focus on very basic books, something that helps me cover the ground, so that I have that base, and then I will work harder to improve that base, and that is what comes with mock tests.
मॉक टेस्ट्स आर द मेन थिंग। जितना ज़्यादा ये सब एक तरफ है, मॉक टेस्ट्स आर सेपरेट। लाइक सॉल्विंग देम अंडर एग्जाम कंडीशंस फॉर 2 hours, दे कैन हेल्प यू मोर देन एनीथिंग इन द वर्ल्ड।
प्रीलिम्स में यू हैव टू राइट अ लॉट ऑफ टेस्ट, सो दैट यू डेवलप दैट पर्टिकुलर वे ऑफ सॉल्विंग द पेपर।
अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट यस, दिस इज अ टफ पेपर, दिस इज हाउ मच आई वांट टू गेस, और दिस इज हाउ मच आई नो फॉर श्योर, दैट कम्स विद मॉक्स।
ये जो वे है ऑफ सॉल्विंग थिंग्स, दैट कम्स ओनली व्हेन यू हैव प्रैक्टिस्ड अ लॉट ऑफ टेस्ट पेपर्स।
इन मोस्ट केसेस यू विल प्रोबेबली नॉट नो द करेक्ट आंसर। मेरे केस में हार्डली न्यू कि मोर देन 40 से 50 का आंसर करेक्टली, बाकी आई टू डिड्यूस एंड गेट इट टू द थ्रू वेरियस मींस।
आई बिलीव दैट देयर इज एन इक्विलिब्रियम ऑफ अ रेंज ऑफ क्वेश्चंस वेयर यू गेट द मैक्सिमम मार्क्स। फॉर मी दैट रेंज वाज अटेम्प्टिंग 90+। I have also seen students who attempt 70 to 75 and they score more than me. So it varies from person to person. And how do you identify that? That identification is important. That can happen with mocks.
Basically, you will realize ki kuch particular cheeze hoti hain. Suppose say number of questions you want to attempt. And so for me, I personally realized ki I am going to attempt around 85 questions. Because I was continuously seeing that whenever I attempt this particular number of questions, I am getting a good score. है ना, आई विल रिकमेंड कि आप भी एटलीस्ट 80 क्वेश्चंस अटेम्प्ट कीजिए, है ना। इफ पेपर ऑब्वियसली इज वेरी टफ, देन मे बी 75 to 80, बट पर्सनली आई विल रिकमेंड प्लीज 80+ क्वेश्चंस रखिए, है ना। बट दैट अगेन डिपेंड्स ऑन यू। कुछ लोग आई हैव सीन अ लॉट ऑफ टॉपर्स, दे यूज्ड टू डू ओनली 65-70 क्वेश्चंस, देयर एक्यूरेसी वाज वेरी गुड। सो दैट विल कम फ्रॉम सॉल्विंग पेपर्स। आप खुद अपना रियलाइज कर जाओगे कि यार ये पर्टिकुलर रेंज ऑफ क्वेश्चंस है, है ना, which when I attempt I am able to score very good marks.
When you are starting with something, go for accuracy before attempts. Many other people say कि यार attempt कितने question करना है, doesn't matter. Many people have scored, attempted 65, got 60 correct and then cleared examination, or 63 correct out of 65. Many do 90 correct and then 25 incorrect out of that. So accuracy becomes very important.
So when you are attempting mocks, try and divide your mocks for try and experiment in March and April. You have a month to experiment. So every set of 5 or 10 mocks, you attempt different set of questions. I began with 80, 80 to 85, 85 to 90, 90 to 95, and I kept switching for 2 months. And I realized that my score was the highest when I was attempting 90+.
So when I did the test series, initially I could only attempt 45 questions, but I tried to get around 41 out of it. When I studied more and more and I revised, this number increased to 55, 65, 75. Like that, it kept on increasing. But my accuracy was also reducing a little bit. So you have to strike that balance as per what your strengths and weaknesses are.
So in the last 3 months, I gave 3 months score to prelims. In the last 3 months, I attempted somewhere around 60 to 70 mocks. I am someone who studies at night till 6 in the morning, 7 in the morning. And during my first attempt, I didn't change the cycle. When I reached the center, and it took me 2 minutes to read the first question. My brain was that dead because it was used to of sleeping in the morning. It wasn't used to of being aware in the morning.
So I started preparing for the UPSC in 2015. That 2015 was my first attempt. And I could not clear 2015 because I did not solve a single test paper. And that was a mistake.
So I changed that strategy this time. I used to attempt, just like Anishak said, I used to attempt one question paper every day from 9:30 to 11:30. That's the timing, I think, in a condition where the fan was off, where the AC was off. Because I realized that when there is no air conditioning or where there's no fan, you tire yourself. And it becomes all the more difficult for you to maintain your concentration for attempting 100 questions. And then you lose out on your concentration and you commit errors.
Then 2016, I corrected my mistake. I solved many test papers. I evaluated myself. I solved the UPSC last year question papers also. So check the pattern of examination. How are they asking the preliminary questions as such? So I worked upon that. I cleared prelims.
And I think prelims examination is more like problem solving approach. ठीक है? आपके पास चार ऑप्शन है. You are like the Sherlock Holmes. आपके पास चार suspect है. You have to find out which suspect is most likely to be the criminal. यहाँ पे criminal हमारे नजर में या UPSC की नजर में. And you have to find that answer either by eliminating others. यार ये तो बहुत सीधा दिख रहा है, ये तो नहीं है, ये criminal.